In today's current affairs decoded session, myself Shivaji Kale, wishes you a good morning. तो आज हम लोग 26 अगस्त की इंपॉर्टेंट न्यूज़ देखेंगे. दिस इज द समरी ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट न्यूज़ एंड आर्टिकल्स. तो इसमें हम लोगों को पर्टिकुलरली ये मार्क्ड किए हुए आर्टिकल्स देखने हैं, दैट इज डिस्कसिंग अबाउट इंपॉर्टेंट आस्पेक्ट रिलेटेड टू एग्जामिनेशन. तो लेट्स गो इन टू द डिटेल्स ऑफ दिस आर्टिकल्स, स्टार्टिंग विद द चाइनाज ब्रिक्स 5G बेस कंसेप्ट. तो एज यू आर अवेयर दैट China has developed 5G technology and its application in artificial intelligence. Other countries are yet to cope up with these technologies. So China is trying to get a market for their technologies, but it is facing a resistance in the international market due to certain factors like trustworthiness related to China, because it's kind of showing dominance in different part of geostrategic locations, example South China Sea. Also, their dominance in manufacturing sector that has led to disruption of global value chain post COVID-19 period, and especially the trade disputes between China and USA and some other countries. So China is also trying to pitch for its own technology through the BRICS forum, जिसमें आप लोग अगर देखेंगे तो Brazil and Russia has already kind of started working with China for enrollment of 5G technology. India is kind of tending towards not allowing Chinese technology, क्योंकि recently हम लोग देखते हैं कि China के apps ban किए गए हैं, उसके बाद में border tension की वजह से भी there is going to be issue. So what is going to be the feature of 5G technology in India, that is going to be a challenging scenario. Moving ahead with the Virat, INS Virat is a aircraft carrier जो recently decommission किया गया था 2017 में, and the purpose after decommission was yet not decided. Many of the states and other authorities has shown interest to convert it into the museum and hospitality, लेकिन the deal does not broke, and hence recently government has decided to scrap INS Virat. तो हमारे लिए एग्जामिनेशन की दृष्टि से इंपॉर्टेंस है, अलग अलग हमारे पास जो नेवल शिप्स है जिसको हम लोग एयरक्राफ्ट कैरियर बोलते हैं, तो INS विक्रमादित्य इज देयर, विच इज 40-ton वेसल विच वी हैव बॉट इट फ्रॉम रशिया. बट लुकिंग एट इंडिजिनियस डेवलपमेंट ऑफ दिस एयरक्राफ्ट कैरियर, INS विशाल इज द फर्स्ट इंडिजिनियस एयरक्राफ्ट कैरियर विच इज हैविंग अ डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ वाटर अबाउट 40 tons, एंड इट इज बींग बिल्ड at Cochin Shipyard. Another is also in the picture, INS Vikram. This is second indigenous aircraft carrier, named after the first indigenous first aircraft carrier that we were using, but it is under the development phase, we can say, but its permission to start the construction has not yet received. Also recently India was in discussion with United Kingdom to build a aircraft carrier. It is also said that India has proposed United Kingdom to copycat its own super carrier named HMS Queen Elizabeth. So discussions are going on, and let's see how it will proceed. Coming to the very important article of today's video lecture, it is about India's capacities in the manufacturing sector, and in the recent period of time there are opportunities when the international foreign players, manufacturing players, those who have invested in China want to take out their investment in the coming period of time, and hence they are searching for different alternative, and India is a natural alternative available to them. But it will not be a sufficient case, because different type of aspects that need to be developed to make sure that India will be a good destination for manufacturing for these players. दीज आर डिफरेंट फैक्टर्स, जैसे कि अगर आप यहाँ पे देखोगे तो इट हैज़ मेंशन कि इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चरल कंस्ट्रेंट है इंडिया में, डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ पॉलिसी एनवायरनमेंट है, नॉन कंक्लूसिव रेगुलेटरी एनवायरनमेंट है, उसके बाद में अदर थिंग्स लाइक वर्कफोर्स का क्वालिटी, लेबर लॉज की रिजिडिटी, ट्रेड पॉलिसी की रिस्ट्रिक्शंस, R&D के ऊपर का एक्सपेंडिचर, एंड लैंड एक्विजिशंस एंड अदर प्रॉब्लम्स दैट इंडियन एरिया फेसेस और इंडियन बिजनेस और मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इकोलॉजी फेचेस, दैट इज मेकिंग इट अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट प्रपोजिशन फॉर दिस पीपल. So the author is suggesting that India should focus upon developing a federal policy where central government and state governments will come together and define this policy to ensure that other states than Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Gujarat, who are actually dominant in manufacturing in the country, other states should also increase their manufacturing capacity, and hence it will be good for inviting these country to India for manufacturing the products. Moving ahead, down but not out, this is related to Islamic State article. And if we are aware about that, 2010 ke baad, matlab this particular decade has shown the rise of Islamic State. Earlier used to be called as ISIS, Islamic State. Theek hai? Then this rise and fall of Islamic State was a period of this particular decade. But even after multilateral engagement with the Islamic State by especially the Western countries and their supports from the local West Asian and North African countries, Islamic State still continues to operate terrorist operations and controlling certain portions of the geography in this particular region. Yes, there is no doubt about that their strength has decreased, their area of occupation has decreased. But the point is that even if they are occupying smaller area and less number of say followers as compared to the earlier, but their ability to strike to different part of the world doing some terrorist activity is still continuing, and that is what the focus of this particular thing, that it has resulted into chaos in the different countries like say particularly Syria, Iraq, Libya and the around countries. So it need to be tackled. So that is all from my side in today's Current Affairs Decoded session. Myself, Shivaji Kale, takes your leave now.
Thank you. Subscribe to Shivaji Kale Current Affairs YouTube channel and hit the bell icon to get the latest updates.